We live in a world ruled by a group of animals that can fit on the tip of your finger. For millions of years, insects have fine-tuned their adaptations to colonize nearly every habitat on the planet. Some have found refuge in our homes. Others have helped control pests in our yards. If there's a niche to be filled, it's safe to say they've probably filled it. The majority of all flowering plants are pollinated by insects, and much of our food crop relies on this relationship. This is merely a glimpse into the small yet seemingly infinite world of insects. Honeybees live in a complex lifestyle known as eusociality, in which there is a division of labor between sexes from overlapping generations. Males, known as drones, are produced from unfertilized eggs. They have no sting, and their primary goal is to mate with the queen. Females, which are the workers, exhibit a wide variety of tasks, such as foraging, guarding the hive, cleaning the hive, and feeding the young. The queen primarily lays eggs and can produce up to 2,000 per day. Queens also produce a variety of pheromones to help regulate the behavior of the workers. There's a wide variety of hymenoptera that also play a vital role in the reproduction of flowering plants. This paper wasp has specialized mouthparts that allow it to gather nectar and pollen. As the wasp visits other flowers, it unknowingly spreads the pollen, thus aiding in fertilization as it forages. While the adults primarily feed on nectar and pollen, they will also forage for smaller insects to bring back to the nest as nourishment for the developing young. Hymenoptera consist of over 150,000 described species, with many more yet to be named. The life cycle for many insects begins in rivers and streams. Larvae can spend multiple years developing and preparing for the moment they molt into terrestrial adults. This mayfly nymph will spend the majority of its life underwater. A flattened, streamlined body and abdominal gills that gather oxygen allow the nymph to live in moving water. The adult stage of the life cycle only lasts about a day. With vestigial mouthparts as an adult, their only purpose is to mate and start the cycle over again. Stoneflies are another common inhabitant of streams and rivers, and are considered an indicator of clean water where they're found. Unlike the mayflies, stonefly nymphs have gills on their thoracic segments, and in conditions of low oxygen, will do push-ups to move water across their gills. There are other aquatic insects mayflies and stoneflies would do best to steer clear of. Megaloptera. Also known as alderflies and dobsonflies have large mandibles, adapted for capturing prey in a vise-like grip. While the adults don't feed, as larvae they will quickly make a meal of a passing mayfly or stonefly. This stonefly will live another day. Insects have some of the most remarkable symbiotic relationships in the animal kingdom. Similar to how we farm cattle, these ants are farming aphids. The aphids spend their time sucking juices from plants, and the ants will use their antennae to stimulate the aphid into releasing excess honeydew, a sugary treat for the ants. The ants will go to great lengths to protect the aphids from predators, and studies have shown them carrying aphids to different plants when predation is high. This is only a very small fraction of stories you could tell in the tiny world of insects, but it's clear we rely on them more than they rely on us.